Welcome back. Here with Bulls Charge Ahead. Now, it wasn't just Dalal Street, but Mint Street or the RBI headquarters just a stone's throw away. Now, Lata, if that is to be taken as a prototype for all the rupee market action, then the rupee didn't want to be left out today. And we've had, what, 20-month highs?
Actually, while the stock market is not the standout performer compared to several other stock markets, if you took a slightly longer term view, you know, if you take a 1 year rolling view, the Russian markets and the Brazil markets have done well. But the rupee under most comparisons has done exceptionally well, has been stable when the dollar index was at 103 and is strong when the dollar index is at 98. It looks like now even the FIIs, you know, we are trying to get a bit of a buy figure in the equity segment. And what is adding to the flows, what I pick up from bankers is that exporters are going ahead and selling dollars. So dollar selling not just by FIIs and FDI, but by exporters who think that, oh God, we missed 65, now we will miss 64 as well, and they're selling forward. While importers who ought to be covering at this level believe that, oh, we will get dollars at 62, why should we cover? So that's also adding to the bullishness in the rupee. I believe the Reserve Bank was in at 64 and supported that level. You will never get this, 100% confirmed. But the Reserve Bank is only trying to remove exuberance and volatility. It looks like for the moment the rupee's march towards 63.50 is what the market is quite prepared for.
Okay, so that's the currency market action. Well, let's get back to equities for now. We have Ashwini Gujral joining in with some thoughts on this ferocious rally and what your next bets could perhaps be. Ashwini, so, I mean, we're looking at 93.50 around close. Tomorrow is also expiry day. What's the index trade, if at all?
The Nifty closed at the all-time high, and now we should expect the next target here should to be about 94.50, 9500. In terms of the Bank Nifty, we should be looking at 22,800 to about 22,900 target next. As far as calls right now are concerned, Mahindra & Mahindra looks like it's going to touch 1,400 fairly soon. Britannia is also breaking out of some sort of consolidation. Out there, we should expect levels of 3,700. And the tire space has been acting fairly well. So SEAT is a call out there, and out there you could expect levels of 1,600.
All right. Thank you very much for those tomorrow trades, Ashwini. Well, actually, the stock market took a quantum leap after the HDFC Bank numbers, if you remember, on Friday evening. Today, I got to speak to the man himself, Mr. Aditya Puri, Managing Director and CEO of HDFC Bank. And he believes, actually, the best is yet to come for HDFC Bank, which means that 20% growth looks like will be bettered in FY18. Listen in.
If you look at the economy, it's growing somewhere between 7.2 to 7.4%. The good things that have happened is you see commercial vehicle sales are up, you see car sales are up, you see that cement numbers are up. There is also spending on roads, highways. You also see renewable energy doing very well. There is a pickup in rural demand. There is a pickup in consumer, there is a pickup with commodity prices, working capital is required. So I think we shouldn't discount that and obviously, finally, I hope people will agree that the demonetization effect was a bit over the top. So if you take all of this into account, the economy is moving, that's for sure. But that's not to take away from the fact that HDFC Bank is probably moving faster. Mm. Lata, in the interviews that we have had, I always told you that we are in a sweet spot. Just wait for the time and it will come, and the time has come. Where we don't have an NPA issue, we are well capitalized. We have the largest distribution network. And we are major in digital banking. So when we are now going out with our products and a complete product range, we've actually put out more people in the market. We've digitized, so our back office people have been released, which go into the market. And the results are phenomenal because we have a superior product offering today, and most of our people are in the market.
I'll come to a superior product in a bit, but still I want to drive home both to viewers and as a background to my question, the magnitude of the rise in the Q4 loans. Look at the quarter one total advances, 4.7 lakh crore. Quarter two, 4.94 lakh crore. Quarter three, 4.95 lakh crore. Just 1,000 crore more. And quarter four, 5.54 lakh crore. I mean, this is a quantum leap in just 90 days. Hence, I am repeating my question. Something has gone damn right in the economy.
Both. And hence, I'll repeat. Don't think this is a stellar performance. Better is coming.
Better is coming as in, I mean, will you be able to go back to your 25% growth days?
We never give...
No, directionally,
guidance.
You're saying...
Directionally, I can tell you, as a combination of what the economy is doing, as a combination of what the benefit that digitization is giving us, as a combination of our product range and our distribution, I think the best is yet to come.
Okay, but give us some indication, because 20% loan growth is what you are ending at, 19.5.
Yeah.
So, can it be even better as early as FY18?
Yes.
Okay. Give me some more emphasis on... do we get to 25%?
Okay, see, I won't...
See, it is a spring effect. Clearly, from Q3 to Q4, is almost a spring effect
I won't give you the numbers, but let me try and give you the pulse and the enthusiasm that we have inside the bank. So if we look at semi-urban and rural India, I think rural economy is picking up as the government spends more and more money there, and they've had the harvests have been good, and if we get a good monsoon, I think that could be a roaring area for us, which is doing very well. You superimpose on the semi-urban and rural economy the digital, where the government needs to be complemented. It makes it much easier to service the last mile.
Okay. Well, let me do one thing. Yeah. I'll get back to the quarter that was.
Okay.
What worked very well? For this 60,000 crore increase in advances.
We grew on our...
Semi-urban?
No, all of it. We grew in our... For the top corporates... We grew in the debt capital markets. That's why we are number two. Mm. And we think we will keep growing there. So we had a major growth in debt capital markets. We had a growth in working capital. Mm. We had a growth in where we refinanced some of the projects. Our SME was a major growth as they're starting the economy. At some point, the economy had to start reflecting the 7.1 to 7.4% growth
exactly.
rate. So the SMEs grew substantially.
Well, you will get to hear more of the Aditya Puri chat, especially his very candid observation that the government must come out and back the banks in taking haircuts. That's the solution for the NPA problem. Thanks for watching this special edition of the Bull's Charge Ahead.